So, folks, a couple things very, very interesting happened tonight, and both are going to put a smile on your face, but for different reasons. One, something very rare united old Donnie, Donald Trump, and Joe Biden. Those men don't agree on much, but they united tonight to mock and utterly destroy the campaign launch of Ron DeSantis, which was, without exaggeration, the worst major campaign launch I've ever seen anywhere, any country, in my entire life. And I've been following politics for my entire adult life, and even when I was like a teenager and stuff. It was so bad. And guys, we have an update that Ron DeSantis' campaign is done. He is already out for 2024 based on what happened tonight. It's already done. It's already over. So I want to play you a few things to just commemorate the one-day campaign of Ron DeSantis. So first, I'm going to play you a meme from Biden and a meme from Trump tearing into him, plus media coverage making it very clear. I'm not going to play you Fox. I only want to play as little Fox News as I can. But even they tore into it. Before I get into the clips, they said on their website, disaster launch for DeSantis and Elon on Twitter. If you want to actually hear Ron DeSantis, tune into us, because unlike the Ron can't do it on his own with Elon, and it only got worse from there, and his campaign is already over.
That was something that we were very proud to do.
So I would embrace proposals, like Paul Ryan offered.
I'm not a candidate.
Do you remember that time that billionaire Elon Musk unveiled the new Tesla Cybertruck? And when he went to demonstrate the vehicle's supposedly bulletproof glass, they smashed two of its windows, even though they weren't supposed to break? Today's Twitter rollout of the Ron DeSantis campaign went kind of like that.
Now it's quiet. We want to welcome you to this historic Twitter Spaces event, and more broadly, a first in the history of social media. Tonight, I'm pleased to introduce two individuals who've done more to loosen the grip. Sorry about that. We've got so many people here.
So let's see.
So they just keep crashing, huh?
Well, it's certainly an incredible honor to have Governor DeSantis make this stark announcement.
Yo, it was like 20 minutes of that. Trump had the golden escalator. Ron DeSantis got the world's most embarrassing 404 error. Over 20 minutes of technical difficulties that sounded like this. That is how the Florida governor's big entrance in the Republican presidential primary will be forever remembered. DeSantis chose to launch his campaign not during a campaign rally, not on a televised event, but on Twitter.com with Elon Musk. And why? Maybe because Musk and Twitter are the best audience for the DeSantis brand crusade against woke.
I view the wokeness as a form of cultural Marxism.
I think it goes back to this woke mind virus that's infected the left and all these other institutions.
We will never surrender to the woke mob. Florida is where woke goes to die.
DeSantis, now officially a 2024 contender, is knee-deep in this kind of impenetrable sphere of contemporary right-wing online culture war fights. Fighting the woke mind virus aligns quite well with Twitter. Its new owner, Elon Musk, has turned the platform into a right-wing forum where he also rails against the woke mind virus, the same ideology embraced by DeSantis. The Florida governor is apparently trapped in this online cultural woke bubble, has chosen, for example, to fight with Disney for daring to speak out against him. Even one of his speechwriters, a guy that he chose to hire, has effusively praised notorious white nationalist Nick Fuentes. That's the guy that's writing his words. I can't tell you for sure, but it does not sound like Ron DeSantis' messaging is necessarily resonating with the Republican electorate. Two new polls released today showed DeSantis trailing Donald Trump by roughly 30 points. Former Republican strategist Tim Miller recently pointed out DeSantis' campaign is a lot like Senator Elizabeth Warren's failed 2020 campaign, which relied on a smaller version of the electorate, a narrow but vocal audience. Tim Miller is a former RNC spokesman and current writer-at-large for The Bulwark. Debbie Moore Cursell-Powell is a former Democratic congresswoman in Florida. Both join me now. Tim, let me start with you, and let me say something you say in the piece, which is that The point you're making, the comparison, is by no means substantive at all. It's purely at this level of like where you're trying to fit in the primary. And one of the points you make is Elizabeth Warren was sort of had this campaign that was electric to a certain portion of the Democratic base that proved not to be big enough to win the primary. You think DeSantis is the same problem. And before we get to that, oh my God, can you believe what happened?
Well, I'm just thrilled because I don't know if you remember, but I was part of the John Huntsman presidential campaign announcement. And we misspelled our candidate's own name on the credentials. We spelled it J-O-H-N, which to me was so shameful and embarrassing. And by comparison, we crushed it. So thank you to the Ron DeSantis team for making our little small gaffe there look very manageable by comparison, because that was just an epic disaster.
I think that's what we just witnessed on this launch. If Governor DeSantis would have just gone to the ballroom there and done an announcement, he'd have had every major network covering it. It would have been, you know, it accomplished a much bigger objective than doing what he did. And it just seems like now no one's going to focus on the message or what he said. It's going to be all about this bumbled launch, which is deprives him of a real opportunity.
Right, because obviously he could have done that, and then, you know, you posted on Twitter. Ashley, tonight's event was called the first in social media history by the moderator, and it was indeed that, right? There were all those technical issues, though. You heard David talking about how they may overshadow the actual message. The auto going in and out took a while to get it started. Elon Musk, though, still singing its praises. Here he is.
There's only so much you can actually fit in a newspaper or a magazine, and there's only one thing you can really put on the cover of a magazine. So that whoever's deciding that is deciding to not talk about other things. Whereas with a public digital town square like we have here, it's possible for the public to choose the narrative.
Was that worth it, Ashley?
Maybe for Elon. I mean, I think what I saw or heard tonight was what felt like a commercial for Twitter. Even from Ron DeSantis, he went on and on about how much he loves Twitter, and then one of the congressmen was talking about Tesla, and I was at that point just saying, what is happening? I thought this was a DeSantis campaign launch. I mean, I think it's interesting that Elon Musk is saying that this is the virtual town square, when we know the algorithm on Twitter, once he has now been the CEO, is biased to making sure that you're only seeing certain type of feeds. Now, he's not going to say that, and I don't expect him to, but folks who are on Twitter are experiencing that, including myself and many other people. So I hope Ron DeSantis gets a huge campaign contribution after doing this from Elon Musk, because he surely did promote Twitter. And I mean, it failed. And I think that will last for a couple of days. But I will pay attention to what Ron DeSantis is saying. And once you get past the failure of Twitter and the launch, it was some of the same old stuff that you heard about Ron DeSantis. Questioning the validity of masks during COVID, talking about over censorship when he's the governor who is trying to censor what students and people can read in the state of Florida. So I can look past the kerfluffle of a failed launch in terms of Twitter, and I am really paying attention to the policies that DeSantis is talking about, because it is a totally different direction he is trying to take the country, and I don't think it's one that the overwhelming population really wants it to go.
So let me ask you, a smooth running campaign, doing it in this format always introduced a huge amount of risk. And what's happening now is that instead of talking about what Ron DeSantis is running on and how he's running, what his campaign looks like, people are going to be talking about how this event went. And there is such a thing as negative attention. And he's right now getting a lot of negative attention, and that's probably going to continue, and it's probably not going to be undone by anything that is said later tonight in a more traditional format. First impressions matter. They matter a lot in politics, and I think that he is learning a really important lesson right now that, you know, if you're going to do something unconventional, you really have to have your ducks in a row and understand how this is working. And as Sarah was saying, there were about 600,000 people in this event. That's not actually that many people. When I checked a couple minutes ago, it was about 300,000. So a lot of people are leaving. Maybe they're being kicked out because of technical glitches. Those are not huge numbers. It should be able to be handled by a competent corporation and a competent campaign. The fact that it's not is, I think, very problematic on both fronts.
Very awkward for the DeSantis campaign, indeed. And Jessica Dean, you're there in Miami. What are you learning about DeSantis's next move?
Well, we just heard him that Twitter Spaces is now up, and he just announced that he is officially running for president. A source familiar had told me he was going to stay there and speak despite the glitches. That is indeed what has happened. So we just heard from him. At this point, it's up and running, and people can hear it. It is the conversation between the governor and Elon Musk. And again, Wolf, the news here is that he did just officially announce that he is running for president. But we're going to continue to monitor this and listen in, and we'll bring you more as it happens.
David Chalian, what do you make of this glitch?
Listen, I think it is fair to judge what you've heard here from my colleagues, that the DeSantis team set this up as, hey, look at this cool thing we're going to do in this totally unconventional way, and it didn't go smoothly. And so that is certainly a fair critique. I don't think it's going to be a long-lasting problem for his campaign. It's already up and running. He'll move on to other things. We will start focusing a lot more, as Alice suggested, on his appeal to voters, his interaction with voters, the policies he's running on. I don't think this will be the definitional moment of the DeSantis presidential campaign, but it's certainly not anyway anybody on Team DeSantis would have designed this. You noted that Joe Biden, the president, and his team started mocking it. Nikki Haley's team has already put out a video of their widely praised launch from back in February. She had a big event in South Carolina. They rolled out video of that praising their ability to launch their campaign. So it's something that I think a lot of insiders paying attention to this will poke fun at. I think at the end of the day, I can't imagine real Republican primary voters making their decision based on a technical glitch.
All right, Jeff Zeleny, you're our political expert. Well, give us the big picture right now. What does all this mean?
Well, if I think David is right, I mean, the reality is this, of course, is not a scripted rollout as Governor DeSantis would have wanted it. But we've always known the most important day is tomorrow, not today. There are many Republican voters who are hungry for an alternative to Donald Trump. That's what this race is indeed going to be about. Perhaps this will be a metaphor. We do not know. But the biggest day is tomorrow. And one of the things that is interesting is the generational argument and the generational change argument that he is hoping to make. He has three young children. He's 44 years old, about half the age of the president, and almost the same as Donald Trump. So he is going to make that argument to conservatives out there.
Like you can see there, all of that, it's just a disaster. And look, Ron DeSantis hasn't formally suspended his campaign. He hasn't. But his campaign is done. I am calling it now. It is over. I was like the first person to call Tucker being gone at Fox. I'm going to be the first person to say Ron DeSantis' campaign is over. As I noted on Twitter, when you launch like that, you are conceding that you are not actually running. His campaign in all but the official paperwork is over and suspended. It is done. I know some people want, you know, they don't want Donald Trump to be the Republican nominee. They want him gone. I want that SOB in jail. But like, if this is what the alternative is going to be, no one's going to, he's not going to beat Trump. As much as we want to think that somebody can beat Trump, and maybe they're not insane like Trump is on policy like DeSantis is, it's not going to happen. DeSantis 2024 is officially over in all but the paperwork. I'm the first to call it, and I ain't wrong.